This video is made possible by CodeNotary.io, tamper-proof notarization for all your digital objects.
Welcome to the Moshix Mainframe channel. This is Sebastian. Today I want to show you one of the first real mainframes that actually joined HNet. It is located in my basement and it is a Z9 Enterprise class. I will show you the room really quick and answer the top questions, like what's your electricity bill and so on. Then we are going to start an awesome application on ZOS. You may have already seen the 3-phase power cables, you need those for the mainframe. The system plus the storage server are drawing around 5000 watts, so it costs me around 1.30 euro to run it for 1 hour. The storage server is a DS6800 and it made me a lot of problems, but finally I managed to fix it. Now let's open up the mainframe and talk about the internals. Now this machine has 2 frames and at the top of the right frame there's the cooling unit. This one works like a refrigerator, so there's gas inside it and a compressor, and it is connected to the book. Now the book contains the CPU and the memory, and it's pretty much the heart of the mainframe, like the motherboard on a normal PC. If we go further down, there are the I.O. cages, and this is used to connect the storage server and the internet to it. So you see there's an Ethernet cable and fiber cables. Now the left hand side frame contains a power supply on both sides at the front and back, and there's also spare room for more I.O. cards or more I.O. cages. Also there are the support elements. What you see here is the DS6800 storage server. It is pretty small for an enterprise grade storage system. Now that makes it ideal for some hobbyists. But it's pretty tough to maintain because those controller cards you see on the back, they are prone to failure. So you need some replacement parts in stock to repair this thing. If you lose both controllers, you have a huge problem. Now these are my replacement parts. I also have some spare discs, so just in case something went wrong, I can repair this. So now, on the other side, we have my management setup. This is an ordinary x86 server inside a mainframe case mod. It runs VMware on it, and I have the hardware management console that you see here. This is the hardware management console of the mainframe, and a virtual machine. So I use the virtual machine for the HMC and the SMC. The SMC is the storage management server, and this is used to manage the DS6800 storage system. Now I opened up personal communications here, and it is already connected to the mainframe, and you see the ZOS logon screen. This is ZOS 2.1. But I also have ZVM on it. So let's try this out. Now we connect to ZVM. So this was made by Moshix, the Atari lock-on screen. Looks a bit weird. Let's take a last look at the setup. Normally mainframers don't see the hardware they are working on very often. And this is for a good reason, because it's pretty loud and you don't want to have too many people in the data center. So let's go upstairs where I built something like an operation center. As you know it from huge enterprises who run mainframes, they have an operation center with huge monitors, and I tried to set something up like this. I did my monitoring with the virtual web access and using the IMON monitor. So my TV is now showing the address spaces of the mainframe of the OS, and we are now ready to start our application. Now I hop over to the laptop in front of me, to the desktop recording. I will start a ZOS session and log on here. Now this is again ZOS 2.1 and it is running Java 8, so quite recent. And what I want to show you is how to run a Minecraft server inside ZOS in a batch job. So for that we will go inside ISPF and look at the started jobs right now. So there's MCX batch, that's the Minecraft job. I will cancel it and we will see it will go inactive just to start it again. So I will show you how to do this. Before that, I've uploaded the Minecraft server inside ZOS and placed it in my Unix System Services directory. It's the job that is used to run Minecraft in batch. It is pretty simple, it is just submitting the commands that we would normally type inside the Unix System Services shell. So we give the directory to the Minecraft folder and start the m.jar, and that is the Minecraft server. We also need some temporary output files and error files, but that's it. And now we can submit it and see what it does. So let's submit the job and look it up inside the IMON monitor so we can see what kind of resources it needs. And yeah, so the Minecraft as the MCX batch address space is very hungry for resources. We see this here as the CPU is on 99%. So this LPart doesn't have all the CPUs assigned to it that are available on the Z9, but it has 3 and 4 gigabytes of memory. So it is enough to run Minecraft, and we can look it up in STCeph. Now here we see also that the job is active and that it is doing something, in fact. So we know that the application didn't crash or something, and it will usually take some seconds for the Minecraft server to start. And after that time, we can try to connect with our Minecraft client. So now this looks okay, condition code 0. The CPU consumption is also going down, so this is an indication that the Minecraft server is already started. Let's try to connect. The mainframe is in my private network with my router. So that's the IP I assigned to ZOS. And now we are connecting to our Minecraft server. And yeah, so this is the university I went to. Let's look at this on my laptop. Now we can play Minecraft and monitor the address space at the same time. And I love it, it's great fun, and I hope you liked the video too. Thank you for watching and see you soon.